They're no good to me dead.
Oh! Mm-hmm. Star Wars nerd.
We're back.
Ooh.
There's a lot of coffee in there.
Oh, there's a lot of caramel, chocolate, Hershey syrup, sugary bullshit creamer in there too. Because the Butler Starbucks is closed today. Random ass Tuesday. They were open yesterday. Leaves are blowing around. They were open yesterday. Closed today. Open tomorrow? I don't know. Seems weird that a Starbucks is randomly closed on a Tuesday. We don't operate on a Tuesday. Glasgow. Can you see it? Where is it? Oh. There it goes. I don't know if you can see it. It's like one of Tommy Boy's trucks. I had every intention. Let me tell you, I had, oh, this blurred, so loud in this neighborhood. I had every intention of coming on here and just bitching up a storm, bitching up, hang on. I'm gonna input the code on my car door. I'm not gonna tell you what that is. Not to, oh, door's getting a little creaky. I'm not gonna tell you what that code is. Because you don't need to know it. Do you need to know it? If you need to know it, let me know. Comment on this video and let me know if you need to know the code to my car door. And I'll let you know what that is. I'll private message it to you. Look. That is... People gotta hate it. It's a private number. So you let me know privately if you want it. And I'll send it to you. Let me just extend this out a little bit. Oh, wow, here we go. Get the wide angle view. Look at all of the stuff. So many boots and some Crocs. Don't worry about those Crocs. Those are daddy's Crocs. Dad Crocs. Croc Dad. Craw Dad. Dad Dingle. I had every intention of coming out here and just bitching and venting and just losing my ever-loving mind over stupidity that I saw recently on the internet. Oh, boy, I was going to fire off. It was going to be lots of... It's going to be lots of negativity, lots of anger, lots of raging, lots of bitching. But I've decided I'm not going to do that. I'm going to talk primarily today, PennDOT, about wrestling-related things. Because it's like Beef has told us many a time, it's WrestleMania season. And WrestleMania season warrants talk of WrestleMania. Wrestling, mania. I'm going to bust out the grill today. I'm going to grill some steaks. T-bone. I'm gonna grill it. I'm gonna put it in my face. I'm gonna clog my arteries up. Oh, it's gonna be awful. Can't wait. It's WrestleMania season, so we're gonna talk wrestling. We're gonna talk a lot of wrestling things. I'm gonna vent about the coffee on the side of the bee. I'm gonna talk about things that I'm displeased about in wrestling. And then I'm also gonna talk some shop about Pittsburgh Potter of a podcast. And things that I want to see be done. Get it done. Be done. Ah, so bright. So instead of venting and bitching, we're gonna take the high road. We're gonna be happy. It's gonna be good. Right? The highlight though, the best part about this video is this. On the latest episode of the Pittsburgh Potter Podcast, go watch it. I'm allegedly a sponsor sometimes. There was a shout out, and I think the shout out was given by our very own legendary man himself, Beef. You know what Beef, you know what he did? Do you know who Beef shouted out? That's right. I made the latest episode of the Pittsburgh Potter Podcast. And it wasn't even my boy Ransom that did it. Ding dong did not do it. Nope. Ransom didn't do it. It was the Beefers, the Beefaronis, the Beef Wellingtons, Beef Tips and Gravy. He shouted out to Trucker Hat Dave. You're welcome and thank you. Thank you and you're welcome, Scotland! I'm gonna steal me a silver stallion. All right, now that that insanity is out of the way. A few things before wrestling. Poot, I'm going to start with you first. Okay, strap in. Are you ready? Poot. Banging motherfucker. I need to know what kind of guitar that was in that song that just played. I've got to know. The main melody guitar sound. I don't, now look, I know you like to go deep cuts here and get into a lot of technical things that I don't give a shit about on many occasions. On the podcast, off the podcast, great detail, and I appreciate when great detail is given where great detail is needed. This isn't one of those times. I just want to know what kind of guitar that was. I don't need to know the make and model, the brand, or who has played it in recent history that has become famous by it. Just tell me what kind of guitar that was. That's all I want to know. I love that guitar sound. Oh, I love that guitar sound. That is, I don't country often. Trucker Hat Dave likes to hee-haw sometimes, but I don't country often. But when I do country, it's the Highwaymen. If you don't know who the Highwaymen is, Bonnie Sutherland? No, that's not right. Chris Christopherson, Waylon Jennings, Willie Nelson, and Johnny Cash. I'm telling you, I don't think I've heard one song that those four guys have done that I have disliked. And I don't country. I don't have the cowboy hat. They're not on the porch. I do have a pair of cowboy boots. I lived on a farm for a while, so don't talk about it. But yeah, I don't country music a lot, but those guys, any day of the week, any day of the week I'd listen to them. They're fantastic. Poot, tell me what type of guitar that was. If you can play that guitar and if you can play that melody, here's what I want. Ready? Poot the Bard's not a sponsor of this channel, but I'll tell you this. Bungo Guitars, I don't want you to make me a guitar because I can't play it. This right here, no talent hack. Can barely hold a camera right. No talent hack right here. The leaves are bouncing down the road, are so noisy. I'm gonna cut ya! No talent hack. I don't want you to build me a guitar. I want you to create a riff for me of that song, Silver Stallion. I'm doing this with my hands like I have any idea what the farm that means. I'll pay you for your services. I will pay you for your music compositional services to give me a little riff or a little something like that, a little song or whatnot that I can play maybe over like a 18 second intro where you see the ransom thing come in every once in a while, maybe a different song. But if you could give me like 18, 19 seconds of that song on that type of guitar, I'd pay you for your services abso-freaking-lutely. Bitcoin, Dogecoin, PayPal, I don't care. I'll send you euros if I need to. It don't matter to me. That's one. Poot, that's one. Two, listen, I hate fitness. And I told that to my wife the other day and she goes, I don't think you hate fitness. I think you love fitness. Well, let me tell you, it's a very much love-hate relationship. I have the leaves. Why are there leaves suddenly? Is it fall? I have the same type of relationship with fitness that I have with beef. It's a very, very fine line between love and hate. I love beef, but damn it, sometimes I wanna just slap the leg, super kick his teeth down his throat. When he gets keyboard warriory on the fucking internets, I wanna drive to his house and I wanna kick his mask down his throat. But I love him, I love him to death. I'd do anything for him, even not kick him in the teeth. So if I was gonna kick him in the teeth and he said, hey man, don't be a dick, don't kick me in the teeth. And my response would probably be, well, I love you, all right, so I won't. So really, I could only kick him in the teeth if he wanted kicked in the teeth. Because if he said don't, I wouldn't because I love him. That was a truck, that wasn't me, if you heard it. I don't know if you did. Listen, I have the same love-hate relationship with fitness. Let's get away from beef. This isn't about that. This isn't about that. This is Poot time. Poot, you bitch, I hate fitness so much. My body hurts. I'm hurting. I am just constantly sore. My legs hurt. My arms hurt. My stomach hurts. My shoulders hurt. For the first time ever, my chest hurts. And I won't say pecs, because daddy ain't got those. But my chest hurts. I was doing chest flies with 20s. Look, hang on. I was doing chest flies with 20s. Now, you might say to yourself, Ransom, 20s? Isn't that pretty simple? Yeah, dude. But look, okay? Look. I don't got a whole lot of ammo loaded up in these guns yet. I'm working on it, okay? I'm working, hold on. See that? There's nothing. There's not a whole lot of ammo there, right? I mean, there's a little bit of ammo, but not a whole lot. So 20s are a big deal when you're doing chest flies at a pretty rapid pace. okay? And like, oh, I've never felt soreness in a chest muscle before. Again, not calling them pecs because they're not there yet. But damn it, everything hurts, Poot. And you and your stupid,
all you're doing is cardio, just doing cardio. You're not doing weights, you're just doing cardio, cardio boy, blah, blah, blah.
I don't think Poot has ever said that, but in my mind, when I'm very mad, when I'm lifting weights and everything hurts, when I'm doing bicep curls, Arnold presses, when I'm doing stupid, whatever this thing is, when you hold the weight and you go, you hold it up here and then you go back and you go up and you work your triceps, everything, every time I'm doing that, all I can hear in my mind is, oh, cardio, bro, cardio, you doing any lifting, boo? Again, Poot has never said any of that, but I hear it in my head and it gets me pissed off. And I hate fitness. I mean, I like it because the results are working. I'm in a large t-shirt. I can't remember the last time I wore a large t-shirt. Pre-college, maybe. It's slowly but surely fading away here. I mean, it's still, you can see it from the side, like, oh, look at my junior. Not by the hair on my, hey. Boba, let's take a rant break here and have some.
Smidgy.
But it's working, but I hate it. I, damn it. So I blame you for this, Poot, okay? I was perfectly happy doing my cardio ended up doing nothing, living life with my stupid twig arms and no muscles anywhere, but I could walk 20 miles a day, walk, run 20 miles a day, fine. I was fine with that. Nope. Now it's all like, well, weights, squats, lunges, weights, bend, lift, bro. I fucking hate you, Poot. I mean, I love you, but boy, I hate you and I hate fitness, but I love fitness and I love you and I hate you. Fitness has been let's get away from that. We're done ranting about that. I want to talk about something else. These? Nope. Wrong way, stupid. Hey, these things? I went to my office for the first time since November? Whenever the last big, like, stupid Governor Wolf, lock it all down, stay it all home, Garfunkel happened in the fall or whatever, winter. Last week was the first time I went to the office since then. And I found these on my desk. Dude, making a video, can you not be loud and windy? World? Yeah, man, yeah. The world makes natural noises, ransom angry. Yes! I expect the entire breathing ecosystem of everything to shut up while I'm doing this stupid talky thing. The president of our company sent me a Christmas present. He sent everybody a Christmas present, but I just found it on my desk and it's these stupid earbuds. Look, this thing, it charges in this dumb little look, again, I don't technology much. So if you're like, hey Ransom, those have been around for a good long time. Are you just discovering them now? Yes, hey stupid. But look, they charge in this dumb little case. And this dumb little case is a charger. You plug this dumb USB thing into a brick, charge. What? Again, look, everybody knows about this. I don't technology much. This is what you're watching here, all the editing and the filming and stuff. That's the most technology that I do. And look, there are these doofy little earbuds right in there. Bing, bing. Good golly, Miss Molly. I've never found a pair of earbuds that wasn't connected to a cord that fit well in my ear. Ah! I can put those in my ear, I can run, I can squat. I was doing squats with these in. God, I hate squats. I was doing burpees. Burpees are the worst. Poot, I can't wait for you to come over here and do this dumb melt con with me because I don't think, I don't think there are burpees in it. Maybe in the warm up there's burpees? Man, I want you to do burpees with me. Oh, mainly because I just want you to feel the pain and agony that my entire body feels every time I try to do a burpee. I hate it. We're off Poot. We're not talking about Poot. Focus, stupid. Damn it. Edinburgh. Glasgow. Scotland! Those stupid little earbuds stay in my ear. Man, they're great. Just discovered them. How cool is that? Man, I love it. We've not talked at all about wrestling. Let's do it real fast because I hate long videos. And boy, I wanted this to be a short one because I have more important things to do than stand in front of this dumb phone, look at my stupid face, and then have to go in here and listen to my stupid face talk as I edit, click, edit, make it all fine. Ransom. God, I hate it. I wish I had the clout or the money or the freaking viewership to be able to hire somebody to edit this bullshit. Was that a...
Yeah, you would.
Oh, I don't... We talked a little bit about it on the Pittsburgh Podcast. Watch that. WrestleMania. I know Beef is getting more and more excited about it.
Ooh, the veins, the veins.
Almost pooped. Oh, I don't... They're... I am weary about WrestleMania this year. Back in front of a crowd, good thing. In an arena, good thing. Not in an empty, weird nonsense, good thing. Hopefully Fiend versus Orton is not what Fiend versus John Cena was, because I thought that was stupid and I would not go back and rewatch it again because boring to me. I get that other people liked it and thought it was very clever, very well done, blah, blah, blah. I didn't, I thought it was stupid. Didn't like it, didn't entertain me. Not overwhelmed, not whelmed, underwhelmed. Underwhelmed. There's a guy back there. Do you see him? See him walking? There he is. He heard me talking about my underwear. I hope that that's an actual match. AJ Styles in a tag match at WrestleMania. What? As far as I know, there's no like multi-man tag, multi-man ladder crazy match. I think there should be. I think AJ Styles will be much better suited in a multi-man ladder match than in a random tag match for the tag team titles. Why? Who cares? I don't care. Again, it's not all about me, but this video is, so I don't care. What else is underwhelming to me? Sheamus versus McIntyre? For the United States title? Why? It's Sheamus not above the United States title by now? He's been a multi-time world title WWE champion, like big belt holder guy. Why are you going back down for this mid-card? Who cares his belt? Can't other people fight for that? And freaking, what's his nuts? Matt Riddle, because people don't have first names, Ransom. He flubbed one of his lines on Monday Night Raw. He was in the middle of his thing and he just goes, oh, I forgot what I was gonna say, and rides off on his scooter. He's absolutely losing that title. I'm sure Vince McMahon was like, dude, you're fired. But you're not fired because we don't want you to go somewhere else and be great, as people want to do when WWE doesn't use them right. So he's probably just gonna get punished by losing that belt to Sheamus. Sheamus, why are you having a mid-card Who Cares East title? I don't know. Put it on Sheamus. Who cares? The Great White. Yay. How is that still available to be a thing? How has there not been an outcry of, you know, that's racist. That's the society in which we live in now. Anytime anything is mentioned, even close to being on borderline, like, oh, they mentioned the color of his skin. Everybody freaks the farm out. Idiots. We're good. Nope. We gotta shift away. I was gonna rant about things, but I decided not to. Positivity. Except WrestleMania. I'm right here. I'm on the edge, Beef. I need you to talk me off the ledge of being negative about WrestleMania. That's Beef's job. Because he can see the light in WWE where I can't. He saw the John Cena, Bray Wyatt, Fiend, whatever the farm. He thought that match was great. I couldn't see it. My stupid little baby brain just was thoroughly unimpressed and unentertained by that. But Beef saw something in it. So Beef's job is to help shine the goodness on what could possibly be a good WrestleMania and talk me off the ledge of thinking this is gonna be stupid. There's that. That needs to happen. Beef, would you help a brother out, please? I need you to help. Lastly, the Pittsburgh Podriver Podcast. You probably heard on the latest episode, go watch it, please. It's a good one-ish, maybe. Beef gets fired up, which was fantastic. It's been a long time since he's raged out about wrestling so much that one of us had to maybe get 911 dialed up and ready, because this guy could have flatlined and we would have needed to punch that send button and make that call super fast. He got fired up and freaked out and it was fantastic. I hope it happens again Thursday. Not the whole almost dying part, but like, man, I miss when Beef would get fired up and pissed off and ragey about wrestling. Like, he went full on Code Green Hulk, not Hulkamania, Bruce Banner Hulk, lost his shit. I miss that. I have a hard time breathing when I laugh that much. Golly, fluff. So good. Anyway, We have this thing on the Pittsburgh Powder of a Podcast called the Choose Your Way Championship. It's our dumb little fake podcast title belt that we defend against each other by picking who's going to win said matches at pay-per-views. Whoever has the most points at the end of the month, boom, they win the title belt. Tom, you can shut up. I don't want to hear your bullshit or your nonsense, dummy.
It's ransom. You've had it a few times. Beef's had it a few times. Bing, bong, bang, and boo, boo, boo.
Yeah, yeah. But at the same time, it flip-flops back and forth between you and Beef. Like it flip-flopped back and forth between Orton and Cena. So, like, yes. I don't think at any point in time in any video that I've ever made have I said, I've never won it. Beef's never won it. But bing, bong, bang. Nope. Open your ears, tickle me, Elmo. I said it bounces back and forth between you and Poot, and on occasion, Beef and I get it. That's a true statement. Once a year, I'm really good at picks. I knock it out of the park, all by happenstance, and I win the title. A month later, I lose it. Same with Beef. He's great. Maybe at WrestleMania, he'll win it, but I can guarantee you this. 1 month later, back around the waist of either the big strong bard or the tickle me Elmo dad. So enough of your hogwash and nonsense. You're out. We have this fake title, and there's an idea that I really want to come into fruition. Beef is on board. I have no idea what Poot's thinking. I think he's a little hesitant, but hopefully I'll put that to rest at the end of this video. You won't see it. I'll send something separate to him. Tom is the real confusatron in all this. I don't understand why Tom wouldn't be like, damn, that is a great way that we can get viewers. We can get people engaged. Hot diggity dog. Isn't that what we want? Coming from a dude who has a profitable, I would think, gaming channel that is completely dependent upon views, interactions, star donations on Facebook. Wouldn't we want more of that? I have no idea why Tom's so against the idea of expanding out. I want this Choose Your Way title to be able to be defended, not only against us, but by any fan who wants to post on our Facebook page, views, comments, likes, things like that, on the Facebook page, post your picks, you go up against us. If we win, in your face. If we lose, what I'll do, and I told these schmucks this, I'll put up my own money by going to a dumb Target, Walmart, whatever, buying one of those stupid chintzy plastic WWE belts. I will send it via FedEx. Shout out to FedEx, not UPS. What can Brown do for you? You can flush. I will send it via FedEx to the winner fan who wins the title. Said fan will then customize that belt how they want. The main nameplate has to have our Pittsburgh Powder Podcast logo on it because it's our belt, dummy. But the side plates, you know what I mean? The one that they customize in WWE, you customize them how you want. As a fan, you put whatever you want on there. If you have a little picture thing, if it... If you have a picture like of a thing or a dude or your face or a middle finger, whatever, you customize that little logo. Dang it! What a great way to get fans engaged, get people talking on our Facebook page, get likes, get views, expand our audience. Hey man, check out this thing. You post a picture of yourself with the belt. Hey, I won this stupid title belt off of these dummies on this podcast. Go check them out. It's super fun. It's a very interactive page. It's a very interactive podcast. Why would we not want viewers? Why would we not want people interacting? Why would we not want likes, comments, shares on our Facebook page? Expand this stupid thing out. I've never been one to be into like marketing or like, hey, let's do this or hey, let's do that. Frankly, at the beginning of this podcast, I could give two shits less. If one person, four people, or just the four of us dummies listening, making it, were the only ones that listened or watched it, couldn't care less. Now I feel like we really have a chance. It's over there somewhere. You can't see it. Motorcycle. Now I feel like we really have a chance. I'm gonna power through. I feel like we really have a chance to expand, to make something great, to make something big. Brrr, I want this to happen so bad. But again, it's not a dictatorship. This isn't Ransom Cast. It's not the Beefburg Beef Driver Beef Cast. We joke sometimes, but it's not that. Beef and I don't hold the majority shares of this podcast. Yet. Could be a hostile takeover, I don't know. But I need I need those other two to get on board with this. I need this idea to come to fruition. I need this to happen. It could be a super big flop. Nobody, maybe two people, maybe Chaos Jester, three people. Maybe this Chaos Jester, maybe Pat, the bastard, the big card maniac, he's all one person. Vapor, you know him from our podcast, Dave, Vapor. Maybe those three people are the only ones who choose to try to win this stupid title. Maybe it goes nowhere. Always a possibility, but we won't know if we don't try. I need us to try. I need us to at least try to open this up and to get this out to our fan base and to make things more interactive on our podcast. Yes, the podcast itself will just be the four of us yucking it up, talking about wrestling, bitching about things that we don't like. WWE sucks. AEW is great. AEW boner, whatever. That won't change. But extracurricular, getting the outside public involved, getting the fans involved on the Facebook page, like, comment, share, post a picture of you winning this title. I'll send it myself. I don't care. I'll front the money for the belt, dumb belt. Is that lint on me or lint on my phone? Oh, it's lint on the phone. Damn it. But I want this to happen. Like, I really think this really could be an avenue to open things up for us and to make things different, interesting, and more interactive. I have no idea. Could be dead wrong. Nothing could come of this. I had drippies. I had to lick them off. Nothing can come of this. It could be the blind hope of a crazy man talking on his back porch to no one. Ooh. It's dripping. Oh, the allergies are kicking in. Oh, a little snot on my hand. Don't worry, I'm not going to shake hands with you. It's COVID season. But that's the thing. That's the podcast thing. I want this to happen very badly. I'm hopeful that fans will start to interact with us. You can't see what I'm doing. I'm going to put my knees up here, stretching my legs. That's what I want. I want a good avenue for the podcast to be able to engage and interact with Sandra. Outside the nose. Okay? Not in. That's in. That's the outside. Okay? Pay attention. Ah, suck my finger in my nose. Now it's even more drippy. Oh, what a horrible chain of events. But that's what I need. I want us to at least try. If it goes nowhere, everybody make fun of this dummy. Hey, look what you tried to do and failed miserably at. Done it before, it'll happen again. Not worried about it. Failure. But hey, gotta keep trying. And that's the positivity that's motivating me to get this done. Failed at many things in my life, will continue to fail. Look at this face. Is this the face of success? No. But one day I will find success with something. Maybe it could be this. Maybe this idea could get us off the ground and expand the Pittsburgh Pod River podcast to a wider audience base, listener base, listenerman, Phil Listenerman. Huh. Maybe it'll get people more interaged. No. Engaged? Kill switch engage. Oh. Maybe it'll get things rolling. That's my hope. Again, could be dead wrong, could be a catastrophic failure. And again, it's an idea that this guy had, so the odds are a little bit higher that it really could just go nowhere. Hopeful though, hopeful. Hey, I was traveling last week for work. That's why there wasn't one of these stupid ass videos for you people to watch. This dumb face, talk about nothing, nothing. Traveling for work last week. Gonna continue to travel for work because we've got some stuff that's happening. I work for a development company. We develop properties. We build buildings, we sell them off. We have some buildings that are gonna be sold off here in the short time frame. So probably gonna be doing more traveling. It was just over to Ohio. I live in Pennsylvania, so I was able to do it by car and not plane because I hate flying. Scares me to death. Went to the shadiest place that I've ever been in the Buckeye State, Whitehall, Ohio. If there's ever a place you wanna be packing in, it's Whitehall, Ohio, good Lord. It's shadier than Mordor. Where is it? There. Shadier than Mordor. Just, there's a drive-through beer distributor in the middle of a shopping center, in the middle. Not on like the end parcel, straight in the middle. Right through. All hours of the day, this thing is busy. We got there at 10 o'clock in the morning. We got to this building on a Wednesday, 10 o'clock, we got to this building, 10 a.m., Wednesday, 6 cars deep. By the time we left that site, 11 o'clock a.m. on a Wednesday, 12 cars deep. It was almost out onto the road. Who is getting that much beer on a random ass Wednesday at 11 o'clock in the morning? Don't you people work? What's happening in Whitehall, Ohio? Anyway, yikes. Yep, need some bodyguards when you go there, because good lord, you'll be stabbed. Stabbed and murdered. You'll be murdered dead. That's way too cold. In any case, traveled last week. Tonight, I will be there for Among Us on the Casual Gaming Dad channel. Here's where we start throwing out sponsors. Please watch this part of the video, even if there's only four of you that watch it. These people are great. Much better than this guy. So check him out. Here we go. Casual Gaming Dad. Check him out on Facebook. Check him out on YouTube. I don't know what all he streams on. Listen to the end of the Pittsburgh Podriver podcast for Poot's diatribe of sponsorships that Ransom gets a very small part of. But check out Casual Gaming Dad. He hosts Among Us tonight. Tonight. Tuesday. Tonight. 9:30. Good lord. I missed 1 week and I can't remember shit. 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Casual Gaming Dad Discord. Show up. Play a lot of games with us. I can't wait. Not oxygen. I don't call oxygen. Where's my face? There's my nose. See? No, we're good. We're good. Not oxygen. Lights. 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 When the lights go down, Ransom goes killing. Lights. Got it? Lights. Woo! No, that's Ric Flair. He woos and then kills. I call lights. 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 Lights, and then I kill. Lights. Is it oxygen? No! Lights! Show up for that. Wednesday, nothing. Well, nothing from us. Tom does probably. He's done getting plugged. Casual Gaming Dad, a Jad. Spit him a phone right there. Damn it, I'm a juicy talker. Casual Gaming Dad, 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Discord, Casual Gaming Dad Discord, Among Us tonight. Kill, kill, kill. Lights, 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 kill. Thursday, we're going to be recording the Pittsburgh Podriver podcast. It's not coming out on Thursday because we don't do live. We do recording. And on Thursday, in the nighttime, we record. I walk. The last time we recorded the Pittsburgh Podriver podcast last week was, I think, like 2 hours, 2.5 hours of recording. I walked 10 miles, 10 plus miles. It wasn't 11 miles. It was 10 point something miles I walked while we recorded that podcast. God, I love the Pittsburgh Podcast. I love P3 nights because I get lots of cardio in P3 nights. Damn, and I love it. See, that's what I mean. Love fitness, hate fitness. It feels great, but I hate how I feel because I'm constantly sore. Ugh. So those usually upload Friday, Saturday. Poot's really good at that. He uploads them really quick. So stick around for that. We're recording Thursday, Friday, Saturday, coming out. Beef? He's gonna get some shit up and running here pretty soon, allegedly. That's what I've been led to believe. I'm gonna have to get my weed eater up pretty soon. The grass is getting wily. Nope, focus, damn you, Ransom. Beef's gonna maybe be coming out with something here pretty soon. Stay tuned for that. That's always gonna be very exciting. The dude, I'm not busting his chops here. This is a legit plug. Beef used to do like Monday Night Raw recaps and things like that. I really enjoyed listening to the way he would analyze things. He's got a very good mind for wrestling, much better than me. I mainly just rant and rave and ask questions because brain, don't brain. Need help the brain. We're back to this again. Brady, help me brain. What time is it? Good Lord. I'll wrap this bull crap up. What? Oh yeah, hey. So I'm looking forward to when Beef gets back to talking about some wrestling because he does a great job with his analytics. The way he breaks stuff down, bug. It's really good. I like it. It entertains me. I'm entertained. Sports entertain when I watch Beef talk about wrestling. So hopefully he gets that up and running soon. Poot the Bard. Check out that guy. He does a lot of guitar stuff. Again, Bungo Guitars associated with Poot the Bard on his channel. Watch it. It's really cool. He does amazing stuff with the guitars that I could never in my wildest dreams do if there was a gun to my head. You have to do this basic thing on this guitar or you're dead. Bye. I'm a corpse. So yeah, he does a lot of awesome stuff. Check out Bungo Guitars and Poot the Bard. Poot the Bard channel. He does game things on there. He does guitar things on there. It's really awesome. That's it. That's the four of us that have things. Me, my channel, Poot the Bard, Casual Gaming Dad. That's also Tiger Bomb Tom, for those who didn't know. Not a racist symbol, not a white supremacy symbol. That's the number 3. 3, 3, 3, 3. Oh, this pinky almost made it up. That would have been 4. 4. Woo! Okay. Damn it. Yeah, I got everybody. We got everybody. I see anybody, somebody, maybe. Tonight, for Among Us at 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, another shout out for stupid-ass Tiger Mom Tom and his motherfucking channel that he gets viewership on, but doesn't want viewership on the P3, because God help us if we expand to get out there. Busting balls, shut your hole. That's it. Maybe next week, if anybody wants to hear me freak out and lose my shit over things that piss me off, if you comment and say, like, hey, be negative and cranky and angry more than you usually are, maybe I'll do it then. But until then, we'll put that on the back burner. Simmer down. Everything will be fine. Have a great rest of your week. Love ya. Not you, but, you know, Beef, Poot, Tom, you guys. Right there. Right in my cold, dead heart. Right in my cold, dead, sore-chested, because I fucking hate weights heart. Goodbye.